Good afternoon. My name is Chris Royce. I'm here to kick off my campaign to be the next supervisor from Woodbridge. I've lived in Woodbridge for 13 years. Came here to work for the FBI. Moved here with my wife, Kathy, and two baby boys, Connor and Cameron. And we've seen Woodbridge in the last 13 years go through a few changes. We added a girl to our family, our Virginia girl, Caroline. And we are very happy to be members of the community there. You know, for the first 9 of the 13 years that we lived in Woodbridge, we had a supervisor who was a true leader. As constituents, we knew that when we called that supervisor, we were going to get a call back, a personal call, to tell us the status of our concerns. And the business owners in Woodbridge, particularly the small business owners, the people that are real American heroes, especially in this economy, because they hire people, they invest in the community, they keep the milk and bread on the table, and they keep our tax base solvent, knew they had a strong advocate on the board. Many people back then said, oh, you people in Woodbridge are spoiled because of the great constituent services you get. What we've come to learn is we weren't spoiled, we were served. We had the service of a leader that we deserve, the people of Woodbridge deserve. And we've kind of missed that here recently from that office. Now, Woodbridge is perceived to have some of the highest crime rates in the entire county. It's perceived to be choked by traffic and a lax, slowed economic development along the Rockland Corridor. And economic development's a fancy word for we need jobs. And unfortunately, many of these things are true. But in these perceptions, the greatness of that district gets overlooked. It's a great, diverse community. Woodbridge is a cross-section of America in one place. It's geographically blessed with its prominent location on the Potomac. And it's full of opportunity, sitting between two military bases and quick access to Washington, D.C. through the VRE. And we have great schools there in Woodbridge, some of the best in the county. And our children, we have them at all levels. We have one in high school. One in middle school, maybe military school, I almost said. One in middle school, you don't straighten up, no. And one in elementary school. Now, due to all this, Woodbridge has the potential to be the prince's crown jewel with the right leadership. As I said earlier, in the 13 years we've lived there, we've seen slow changes. And in the last 4 years in particular, we've seen us, in particular our family, and our neighbors, what seems to be a slow momentum in Woodbridge. And that's why it's time for new leadership. Now, a few years ago, it became very cool for a certain politician to have a four-word slogan to shape his campaign. Now, I've been talking to constituents in Woodbridge and small business owners alike, and they've given me two words in a phrase that I'm going to use to frame this campaign. Now, those two words are fix and now. Now, once elected, I'll bring 26 years of leadership experience to the board for the people of Woodbridge. My participation in local committees, my international work, most prominently and recently, my assistance in helping with the reconstruction of Haiti after the country was ravaged by the earthquake. From my business experience, 10 years in the defense industry as a business manager, business developer, honing those skills and validating them through a graduate business degree from George Mason, as the next supervisor from Woodbridge, I will raise the bar in terms of leadership and business acumen on this board from Woodbridge. I'll lead us to rapid economic development along the Route 1 corridor. And what I'm gonna do is bring changes to that road that the people have only dreamed of. Because the path to prosperity for Woodbridge is only through economic development. And I'll do this through a sense of inclusion, not exclusion ever. I'll ensure our first responders have the budget they need to keep us safe, because as all of you know, my motto, Homeland Security begins in the hometown. And I'll work with all elected officials at all levels necessary to ensure our traffic issues are resolved. But most importantly, I'm going to return a personal touch to the Woodbridge Supervisor's Office. And I'm going to do that through the application of my leadership style that's renowned throughout the industry. And that is a person that builds teams and is all-inclusive of all stakeholders. Now, that's a whole lot of words to say the following. You call me, I'm going to call you back personally. I'm going to come to your house and visit you. I'm going to be at the meetings I'm supposed to be at, and I'm going to follow through on the things I promise. What I want to point out now, though, is one of the other things I'm going to do is I'm going to work with this leader right here, this lady, Potomac District Supervisor Maureen Cadigan, as a team on the Route 1 corridor. We're going to take a systems approach to that corridor, and we're going to lower crime, reduce traffic congestion, and increase economic development. Now, at this time, I'd like to thank you, Chairman Stewart, Supervisors Cadigan, Sturup, Covington, May, Noe, for your leadership on the board and your continued support of my campaign, and for your work, Chairman Johns, on the school board, and for your endorsements. Most importantly, I'd like to thank all of you for coming here today and supporting me in this kickoff. But the people that I'm thanking the most are the people I love the most, and that's my family. So with that, I will wish you a great day, and I will see you on the trail. Thanks for all your support.